as French troops head to Mali for what promises to be the start of a large-scale international effort to root out Islamists from its northern territories, President François Hollande has been lauded both at home and abroad for what many see as a bold decision to respond to urgent requests for aid from the West African nation. French newspaper Le Monde went as far as to speak of national and international consensus on the intervention, and certainly at home the political classes appear to have formed a bloc of support behind the socialist leader. Aside from adulations from his own party, Hollande's right-wing opponents in the UMP tweeted their support of the move in a rare show of unanimity on a highly fragmented political stage. On the street, however, analysts predict that Hollande may have a tough time disassociating himself from the shadow of the previous president, Nicolas Sarkozy, whose popularity soared over his support for popular uprisings and intervention in Libya, only to sour shortly after as political chaos continued and Islamist influence grew. Analysts predict that this could either make or break the future of President Hollande, whose popularity ratings are at an all-time low. While some cybernauts have set up international Facebook communities in support of the intervention, with Francophones from across the world logging in to thank the French leader, others are skeptical that sending in more troops and weapons could be the solution to ending Islamic insurgency in Mali and the Sahel region. Many are concerned over the fate of around 6,000 French nationals currently living in Mali and of at least 6 hostages being held by Islamist militants in the region, one of whom was reportedly killed in a bungled rescue attempt along with 2 soldiers. The victim was reportedly being held by Islamist group Al-Shabaab, which is loosely affiliated with Mali's Ansar Dine militants.